Hello everyone. Einstein's theory of relativity treats time as a dimension, just like the usual three dimensions of space. But is it really a dimension, and what does it really mean for time to be a dimension? Let's find out. First, what do we mean by time? Time is kind of a continuous flow of change. Without time, the universe would just be static, unchanging forever. Nothing will ever happen in a universe with no time. Think of the universe as a video. A video has two dimensions of space and one dimension of time, like this video which you are currently watching. Now, if time would not have been existed, the universe would not have been a video. It would have been an image. Like if you pause this video right now, you will just see an image in which nothing is changing. Time is kind of a continuous flow of events, and it allows things to move or evolve. And what are dimensions? Dimensions are kind of degrees of freedom. The universe has three spatial dimensions, implies we can have three degrees of freedom or three independent directions to move in space. Any motion we do in space is a combination of the three spatial dimensions. But spatial dimensions aren't the only type of dimensions. Time, just like space, can also be understood as a dimension. We all are moving through time, just like we move through space. The difference being, we can stop our motion through space, but we cannot stop our motion through time. Every object in the universe that has mass has to move in time, inevitably. There are many situations in our day-to-day lives where we unknowingly treat time just like a dimension. For example, consider a situation in which you want to meet someone. You can't just provide him the location of the place where you'll meet him in the three dimensions. You also have to specify a location in time, like 4 p.m. or 5 p.m. This would be the complete information necessary for someone to get to meet you. The three spatial dimensions aren't enough. The location in time is as important as location in any other spatial dimension. To describe an event in space-time, in addition to the three dimensions of space, we also need a dimension for time. Knowing when an event takes place is as important as knowing where it has occurred. Many people have trouble accepting the idea of time being a dimension. One of the problems people have is that time only flows forward, while we can traverse spatial dimensions in either direction. So why do we only move forward in time? See, there are scenarios in our universe where something similar happens to the spatial dimensions as well. For example, inside the event horizon of a black hole, space flows faster than the speed of light in the inward direction. In that case, we can't move in the opposite direction, as nothing can move faster than the speed of light. And it's similar to how we can only traverse time in the forward direction and not in the backwards. So would you not consider that fast and light inward flowing direction a dimension anymore? Most physical laws and equations of physics are time symmetric. That means they work the same both forwards and backwards in time. For example, if you take a pendulum and let it swing, you won't be able to tell if time is going forward or backward, assuming the experiment is done in a vacuum and no energy has been lost to the surroundings, which generally is not the case. Now, not all physical laws are time symmetric. One of those is the second law of thermodynamics. And a lot of physicists think that the direction of time has a connection with the second law of thermodynamics. The second law of thermodynamics says that the entropy of a closed system always increases or remains the same but can never decrease. Entropy is actually the measure of randomness or disorder in a system. Ice has less entropy compared to water because ice is cooler than water, thus have less random motion. Now, an ice cube melting into water can be distinguished with water freezing into an ice cube. Or in general, the increase in the randomness of a system can be distinguished with the decrease in the randomness of a system. That means we can tell if time is going forwards or backwards. If randomness in a system is increasing, time is going forward. And if randomness in a system is decreasing, time is going backwards. In a sense, the second law of thermodynamics is one of those laws in physics which distinguishes between the forward and backwards flow of time. Basically, the idea is that time moves forward because entropy of the universe is increasing with time. The universe has started off from a low entropy state, the Big Bang, and is going towards high entropy state. In the far future, the universe will eventually reach its maximum entropy state. At that time, there will be nothing to change in the universe. And this is known as the heat death of the universe. So will time stop at that moment? Some physicists think that at that time, the law of increasing entropy and the direction of time can reverse themselves, leading to a universe shrinking in size. Some of the theories predict that during the Big Bang, two universes were created, one with forward flow of time and the other with the backwards flow of time. But all these are mere speculations. We don't have any evidence for any of that. Before 1900s, people believed that space and time are absolute. 1 second in this part of the universe is 1 second in any other part of the universe. Time was thought to be independent of everything. This all, however, changed with the advent of Einstein's theory of special relativity in 1905. Einstein showed us that space and time are not absolute. Time can run at different rates depending upon the motion of an object. Events that are simultaneous from one observer's perspective may not be simultaneous from someone else's perspective. Time can slow down for observers in relative motion. In a sense, there is no ultimate past, present, or future. The idea of time being the fourth dimension after the usual three dimensions of space was first introduced by Hermann Minkowski, not Einstein. Minkowski showed that the theory of special relativity given by his former student Albert Einstein can be understood as a geometric theory of four-dimensional space-time, now known as Minkowski space-time. Now, to understand what it really means for the universe to be made up of four-dimensional space-time, three dimensions of space and one of time, consider a situation. Let's say you are driving a car from line A to line B. The distance between line A and B is 20 meters. The velocity of your car is 10 meters per second. At first, you took the horizontal path between line A and B, and it has taken you 2 seconds to cover the distance. In the second run, you took the path that is at an angle to the horizontal path, and at this time, it has taken you a little more than 2 seconds to reach line B. On the third run, you took a path that is at 90 degrees to the horizontal path, and this time, you'll never reach line B. So what actually has happened? Why it has taken you longer to cover the horizontal distance of 20 meters in the later runs of the car? What actually has happened is that in the later runs of the car, you are not only moving in the horizontal direction, but also were moving in the vertical direction. And because of that, your velocity has been divided in the horizontal and vertical direction. Your total velocity was still 10 meters per second, but your velocity through the horizontal direction has decreased, and the velocity through vertical direction has increased. And this is the reason why it has taken you longer to cover the horizontal distance of 20 meters in the later runs of the car. And on the third run of the car, your complete velocity was through the vertical direction. That means you were not moving in the horizontal direction. Thus, in this case, it will take you infinite amount of time to reach line B. So what does all of this has to do with time being a dimension? See, as we accept the notion of time being a dimension, awesome insights come into picture. Hermann Minkowski showed in 1908 that space and time are connected. Time is also a dimension, just like space. Now, it turns out from the mathematics of special relativity that everything in the universe travels through space-time at the speed of light. I highly recommend this video by Sabina Hossenfelder if you want to know how this mathematics really works. Now, as time is also a dimension, we also travel through time. And our combined velocity through space-time, three dimensions of space and one of time, is precisely the speed of light. Now, relative to you, your velocity through space is zero. Thus, your velocity through space-time does not have any velocity through space. Thus, all of your velocity is through time. And as the velocity we travel through space-time is precisely the speed of light, while at rest, we travel through time at the speed of light. And as we start moving through space, our velocity through time decreases, just like how the velocity of the car decreases in the horizontal direction as we start moving in the vertical direction. And when something moves through space at the maximum speed, the speed of light, its motion through time becomes zero. Or in other words, the object will not experience the flow of time. This is what happens with massless particles like photons, the particle of light. They travel through space at the speed of light, thus does not travel through time. Similar to when traveling at 90 degrees to the horizontal path, our motion in the horizontal direction stops. And this also explains why nothing in the universe can travel faster than the speed of light. As everything in the universe travels at one fixed speed through space-time, that of light, the maximum speed someone can move through space is speed of light. Also in general relativity, gravity is the curvature of not only space but also of time, giving us clue that space and time are connected in a fundamental way. Here on Earth, gravity is mostly the curvature of time. The gradient of the flow of time in different heights above Earth manifests as an illusion of a force pulling things down, which we call gravity. Einstein's theory has given us new insights into what space and time really are and how these are connected. Time is also a dimension, just like space. Obviously, time is a different kind of dimension than space in many respects. For example, we can move in space in either direction, but in time, we can only move forward. Space and time are connected. And in Hermann Minkowski's words, space by itself and time by itself are doomed to fade away into mere shadows, and only a kind of union of the two will preserve an independent reality. He spoke these words in 1908 in his famous talk, Space, and time. While making this video, I was wondering what can be the best definition of time. Time is something that we all are familiar with, but still it's very hard to define what time actually is. Tell me in the comments, how would you define time? If you have something to ask, you can obviously ask in the comments. Thanks for watching. Bye.